Hello, everyone, and welcome to the very first Giant Slayer LOR Fight Night Legends preview. We've got 8 of the best players in the world competing this Friday, June 26th, 5 Eastern, for a shot at a $200 prize pool here, Giant Slayer TV. If you're familiar at all with the LOR esports scene at all, you're going to know basically every single one of these names. If you've watched any tournaments, if you've just paid attention at all to Twitter, LOR esports at all, you're going to know these people. But don't worry, if you're brand new to LOR esports, I'm going to go through some of the highlights from all of these players that you're going to be seeing this Friday. Start off, got a big one. Many of you probably already know him. It's going to be Hype, the man who needs no introduction, but I'm going to give him one anyway. Representing Team Liquid, Hype is one of the biggest CCG streamers out there today. Started off actually in Overwatch, and I've been following him since then. Played some Artifact, was actually known as one of the best Artifact players, at least from a tournament level, period. He's also highly ranked in auto chess and is, or at least was, an avid TFT player. Hype has already made a little bit of a name for himself in the LOR scene, making a number of top cuts and deep runs in tournaments, a bevy of day two finishes. So definitely going to want to keep an eye out for Hyped at this event. Up next, we've actually got a trio, 3 different players from the, it's early to call it, but the power squad in Legends of Runeterra, Team IQ. First up is Sujarkan, who's made a name for himself pioneering a Freljord Bilgewater mid-range deck. You see it a lot now on ladder, but way back in the day, Sujarkan was playing the Sejuanis and MFs and all of that way before it was cool. And he was pioneering it, really pioneered it and played it super well, made a lot of top finishes, but actually recently threaded the needle and got a victory at one of the weekly NA events. And actually, as I'm reading this right now, earlier today, won this past weekend's BR Fest event. I didn't check out the deck list yet, but I would imagine there's probably some Freljord Bilgewater midrange. Ian Nguera is the second player in this trio. He's been a mainstay day two performer in the LOR weekly events. Ian Nguera and Sujarkan are actually both Brazilian players. So while NA and EU have been sort of at the top of mind, at least from our perspective, and from what we've seen in the LOR scene, they have been doing a solid job of representing Brazil in the LOR esports scene. And let me tell you, from commentating and looking at these chats, the Brazil crew comes out strong for these players. Definitely keep an eye out on that. And if you are from Brazil, you're definitely going to want to watch these two compete this Friday. Last and certainly not least from Team IQ is the one and only Nola Gold. Jody MF Keith himself is in the building and vying for the first Giant Slayer LOR Fight Night Legends title. I know I got a little bit of crap on Twitter for not mentioning Nola Gold in my Papa John's promo video. Sorry, I didn't name every single player that's out there, but let me tell you, Nola Gold deserves to be in this event. He has won a Magic the Gathering Grand Prix, actually GP Memphis in 2019. Now, if you're not familiar with that, I come from the Magic the Gathering background, so I understand and appreciate just how crazy of an accomplishment that is. It was a nearly 1,000 player, 2-day in-person event. So certainly not something to sneeze at. A huge professional level tournament that he took down himself back in 2019. He's also most notably the player that, at least from my perspective, has pioneered the Ionia Noxus combo deck known as Kickaxe. So I would imagine we might be seeing a little bit of that this weekend, or this Friday rather. Cephalopod is another NA player that you will recognize if you've watched any day two of, if you've watched the day two of any NA event. He is almost always there. He's actually gotten victories against a lot of the other players in this event, but you know, it's kind of rough. Well, on the one hand, it's great because he has a lot of second place finishes, a lot of top fours, top eights. Hasn't quite been able to thread the needle. Has gotten wins against a lot of these players that are in this event, but has not quite gotten that title. We will see if he can take it home this Friday. Next up, we've got a pair of EU players who, while being in Europe, have actually been playing in both the NA and EU regions. Presto and Fresh Lobster have been recently working on tournament lineups together alongside the Australian player G'day Maverick. They have been sort of the three-player brain trust that has been dominating the competitive scene the past couple of weeks. Notably, Fresh Lobster took a Duels of Runeterra tournament, I believe it was last week or the week before, and I believe between Lobster, Presto, and G'day Maverick, they had some insane win rate going into that, or playing in that event, all running the same lineup. Absolutely two to look for in this event. And Fresh Lobster comes into this event with actually somewhere upwards of five tournament wins, not just top finishes, not top eights, not top cuts, not that, wins. There hasn't been that many tournaments played, I gotta say. So Fresh Lobster is one of, if not the most decorated player in LOR right now. He is absolutely one of the scariest opponents in LOR. He plays just a very mental and very deliberate game. It's a treat to watch, and you're definitely going to want to check it out this Friday. And as I wrap up the video, there's one more player that I haven't mentioned yet. This is Winding God, and he is arguably the scariest player in LOR. So he actually is in the Asia region, I believe from China, based on his name, which is usually in Chinese characters. Winding God has absolutely dominated NA events for months. It's either most of these events are either Fresh Lobster or Winding God, and they tend to trade off. Winding God has won an unprecedented three Duels of Runeterra tournaments in a row. So Fresh Lobster's won five total tournaments. Winding God has won three in a row, which is just insane. Across different decks, playing different, it's insane. Winding God and Fresh Lobster have actually changed the way that we play and look at competitive Legends of Runeterra these days. They play a much more deliberate, it's much more grindy and getting incremental advantages. Casanova and I have coined the phrase of the lobster pass, where you're actually, your opponent presents you the option to pass the turn with you having played nothing or played very little, not even attacked, and Fresh Lobster and Winding God will take that pass just to get the smallest amount of incremental advantage, trading your attack token for a small amount of incremental advantage, and it has completely changed how the competitive scene is and how the game is played at the highest levels. It is absolutely amazing to watch both of these players, and we've got both of them along with all of the other players I've mentioned this week. Week number one for Giant Slayer LOR Fight Night Legends. Whether you're brand new to the scene or you've watched them all, like myself and my co-caster Casanova, this first week of Fight Night Legends is absolutely gonna be legendary.